The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Welcome back, children. So, from our previous chapter, that is Food for Health, we have understood the importance of food that we consume. We also are aware of the significance of breakfast, lunch and dinner. Breakfast should be usually consumed by 8 to 8:30 a.m., lunch before 1 p.m. and dinner we have to consume before 8 p.m. So for the proper consumptions of all these meals, you have to wake up early. What time should you get up? At least by 6:30 to 7 a.m. So make it a habit that you get up as early as possible, at least by 6:30. Now we don't have schools, right? So make it a point that you get up at least by 6:30 to 7 a.m. Get yourself involved in some sort of physical activities, some a few minutes of walking, watering the plants. So make a point that you get involved in some sort of physiological activities, okay? So these activities will definitely improve your metabolism. What is metabolism? All sorts of physiological activities that is happening to your body, like respiration, digestion, excretion, all sorts of activities that is happening inside your body are called metabolic activities. These metabolic activities will definitely be enhanced once you get up early and start doing, getting yourself involved in some sort of physiological activities. HDI. It is Human Development Index. This is an index given out by United Nations, where we have some rankings of all the 189 countries. This ranking is based on three aspects: health, education and per capita income, which is the living standards. According to this, our country stands in the position of 131. Actually, compared to last year, we have slipped down to two more ranks below. Last year it was 129 and this year it has become 131. How about the different states in India? You must be happy listening to this. Kerala stands first in the ranking with good development, better development than the other states in the three aspects, that is health, education and living standards. Children, you are the future citizens of India. Don't you want to improve this rankings? So everything lies in your hands. All these simple efforts, that is small efforts you take, will make others also do the same. So getting up early, getting involved in some physiological activities or physical activities, getting some fresh air, helping out in watering the plants, helping out your parents, all these small efforts will pile up and they are definitely going to show some progress in all the three aspects, that is health, education and per capita income, that is living standards. In these three aspects, health stands first. Waking up early is definitely going to bring out some improvement in your health and it is definitely going to keep diseases at bay. What do you mean by at bay? At distance. So today we are going to move into our new chapter, that is 8th chapter, keeping diseases at bay. How can you keep diseases at bay? For that you should be mentally and physically competent, right? How can you keep yourself mentally and physically fit? Shall we move into the topic? So children, our 8th chapter, that is keeping diseases at bay, it starts with a small story about Appu. Appu was a very good student who has a very good aptitude for science. He wanted sincerely to participate in the state level science fair. He came first in the sub-district fair level. Suddenly, he caught up with a fever. Parents took him to a doctor. He was given medicine, but even then, fever did not subside. Later on, it was diagnosed as dengue fever. Because of this dengue fever, he was not able to participate in the state level science fair. So you can imagine how Appu would have felt, how badly he would have felt for not participating in state level fair, isn't it? Sometimes this happens, right? We might be very positive to participate in items, but our health will not be so positive, right? This always happens in everybody's life. So why do we catch up with diseases? What is the reason? Can you come across some diseases that you are aware of? Commonly we come across cold, fever, stomach pain, anything else? Now we are coming across a pandemic, that is corona, right? Which is caused by a virus. So there are lots of diseases that we come across, isn't it? How are these diseases transmitted? Are they contagious? So I hope you are familiar with the word contagious. Contagious means spreading from one person to another person. How is it transmitted? So transmitted is another word, that is the mode of spreading, okay? Is it transmitted through air, through water, through food, or something else, okay? So how are these diseases going around? How are they transmitted? We know that mosquitoes cause some sort of diseases like malaria, filaria. Rats can cause us diseases like, yes, plague, rat fever, all that. Likewise, house flies also can cause diseases like cholera, stomach pain, dysentery, all that, isn't it? So these are some of the modes through which diseases are transmitted. Look at the picture that is given in your textbook. They have given three types of microorganisms, that is bacteria, virus, and fungus. So these three are microorganisms. What are microorganisms? Diseases are caused by the action of microorganisms like virus, fungus, and bacteria. Diseases spread when these microorganisms get transmitted from one infected person to another person. So all the diseases are caused by microorganisms. What are microorganisms? They are very small organisms which cannot be seen through naked eyes. They can be seen only through microscope. So what are they? We are coming across three sorts of microorganisms, that is bacteria, fungus, and virus, okay? So these are the three microorganisms which aid in transmitting diseases from one infected person to another infected person, okay? Now that we have understood that microorganisms are the ones who spread diseases, let us also come across those which are carriers of diseases, okay? Look at the pictures that is given in your textbook. See, you can see flies coming and sitting in the food items. Okay, how does this house fly transmit diseases? It's very simple. Flies, they will sit in the dirt. With the same legs, they will come and sit in the food item also. So imagine if you eat that food, if you consume that food, what happens? it will lead to cholera, dysentery, all sorts of diseases, right? So house flies help in transmitting the disease. Other than microorganisms like virus, bacteria and fungus, house flies also help in transmitting diseases. So we can conclude that diseases are transmitted through water, through air, through food and through creatures. So these are the four modes through which diseases are transmitted. Diseases transmitted from one person to another are called contagious diseases. Common cold, conjunctivitis, cholera, typhoid, chikungunya, dengue fever, filariasis, jaundice and rat fever are some common contagious diseases in our place. So children, common cold, it is caused by bacteria. Conjunctivitis, again virus or bacteria. Cholera, it is caused by flies. Typhoid, that is also caused by a microorganism. Chikungunya, it is by mosquito. And dengue fever, again mosquito. Filariasis, mosquito. Jaundice, yes, it is caused by flies. And rat fever is caused by rat. So what are the four modes through which diseases are transmitted? Through air, through water, through food and through creatures. And these creatures may be virus, bacteria, fungus, flies, mosquitoes, etc. Rats also, okay. So we will see another table where it is given mode of transmission and diseases transmitted. So through air, if the disease is transmitted through air, what are the diseases you get? Common cold, chicken pox, measles and tuberculosis. So if the disease is spread through food and water, and what sort of diseases you will get? Rat fever, typhoid, cholera, jaundice. And if it's a house fly, you will get diseases like cholera and diarrhea. If it's a mosquito, filariasis, malaria, dengue fever, chikungunya. And if it is through contact, what do you mean by contact? By touch. You get diseases like conjunctivitis and leprosy. Now you have understood that different diseases spread in different ways, right? Now from the in the beginning of the chapter, I told you about Appu. Now tell me, how did Appu get dengue fever? Yes, through mosquito bites. So should be careful that mosquito doesn't bite you. Protect yourself from mosquitoes, okay? So all these are the different modes of transmission of diseases that we are aware of now, okay? What is the major disease that we come across now? Yes, it is corona, isn't it? And what is the mode of transmission here? Again, we have a virus called coronavirus, which is spreading diseases, isn't it? So we are learned to fight against this virus and live along with the virus. How are we successful in doing that? By protecting ourselves from mask, isn't it? We go out wearing masks, we keep ourselves at social distance, we maintain social distance and we sanitize our hands often, and when we go out and return back home, we protect ourselves by taking bath, isn't it? All these we do to take precautions against the disease caused by the coronavirus. It's a virus that is causing all these diseases. So children, let me stop here. We will see what happens, what more diseases are there to study about, and we will continue in our next video session. Bye children, take care and make sure that you get up early, involve yourself in some physical activities, okay, and take care of your health. Bye.